Hello, I'm Colin Wilson. I facilitated the sales and enablement session. We ran three sessions, three groups, very mixed audience, different people in different positions from different countries. And what we asked were, what were their biggest challenges? And I think most people had sales forecasting as a big challenge to make it accurate. Other people wanted to know how they should be managing their sales teams. We had ideas on recruitment in terms of bringing different salespeople in. Some people were concerned about the mix in terms of indirect sales, in terms of people field sales force. That's it. Can't think of the word. Field sales force. So inside sales, field sales. How's the mix? And we had some lively debate around commission plans and how to motivate people. Before we started, I wanted to frame what the sales environment looked like, because I think it's very, very important for people to understand there are different types of sales strategy. And in my experience, people have confused this in the past. And so I presented three basic strategies. Little tongue-in-cheek, in terms of a little bit humorous. So the first one was spray and pray. How do I get out to as many people and I pray they're going to buy? Then there's one called showing hope. Let me show you my product and I hope you're going to buy. And the third one was involve and close. How do I involve my customer in the process and I will close? Interestingly, most of the audience had a data center background, server, storage, and they should be in the enterprise space. They should be using what I call the involve and close strategy. But most of the sales teams were using show and hope. They come along, they'll show the customer the product, and they hope they're going to buy. And we had quite a debate on, well, what are the characteristics of those three, and how do I move my team up? On the commission plan side, people was quite interesting. Those that wanted more accurate forecasting were actually paying incentives or accelerators at the end of the year, when good practice would be actually to pay accelerators every quarter, because you want four times someone to overachieve, not at the end of the year, it's too late. The other thing there is people making it too complicated. And if a sales guy cannot work out their commission, then that commission plan is too complicated and it's not actually going to do its job. We also looked at forecasting, and forecasting is quite a complex subject, but the best example I can give, there are only two outcomes in sales. You're either going to win or you're not going to win. There are no percentages, so you have to get your salespeople to forecast the deals they're going to win, and they're going to hate doing it. And the reason they hate doing it, because they don't know. So at least you then find out. And the third one, we spoke about qualification. And I asked people the three top qualification questions. Some of them got them right, but I'll give them to you now. The first qualification question, so if you're managing your team, if you want to find out if the deal is real, ask them when it's going to close. That's the first question. When you've asked them that question, ask them, does the customer agree with you? And then what you'll find is most time they don't. You're in trouble. If your sales guy's going to one day and your customer's not working to it, it's not going to close. And then the third one is to test the commitment. Get them to ask the customer how long they can delay the decision. And what you're doing now is testing. Everyone talks about the compelling event. It's only compelling if it's compelling in the customer's mind. If they give you a delay time, the deal's going to be delayed. So the salesman's not doing their job. They've got to get to a place where the customer says, I can't delay this. And I think that's probably the biggest takeaway for most people.